I'm Jesse. Let's see how Jesus responds when Judas pretends to care about the poor by calling out Mary, who's just poured out, not the mother of Jesus, but the sister of Martha and Lazarus, for pouring out this expensive perfume and drying Jesus' feet with her hair in an extravagant act of worship. Jesus answered, "Leave her alone. She has kept it for the day of my burial. For you always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." Now, what Mary just did evokes something that the Magi did, the wise men did, shortly after the birth of Jesus, when they bring gold, frankincense, and myrrh. There was, within these gifts, a foreshadowing of Jesus's coming death. And what Mary just did, Jesus said, "Prepared me for my burial." He knows what's coming. This is only 6 days before the Passover, and we know that this is going to bring with it the crucifixion. And what Mary just did was an extravagant act of worship that prepared him for his burial. He knew what was coming, even in a way that his friends did not. "For you will always have the poor with you." What does that mean? Right? We know realistically we're going to have the poor with us. We know that this side of heaven, there's no governmental or economic system that's totally perfect. We can see an ideal setup at times in the law of God. For example, in the book of Deuteronomy, the book of Numbers, we can see these ideals set up that there would theoretically be no poor, but we as fallen men do not adhere to the law of God. Not even if we do ostensibly, we don't really do it in our hearts. See the Sermon on the Mount. The ideal is that there would be no poor among us, but in the meantime, we're always going to have the poor. Besides, the bigger picture of what was happening in this extravagant moment of worship was Mary pouring out at the feet of Jesus something to prepare him for his burial. And what Jesus was answering was Judas's virtue signaling claim, like he wanted to sell it and give it to the poor while actually keeping a piece of it for himself. So with that context in mind, Jesus just gave a glimpse of the coming crucifixion, and he gave us an important teaching as well. We're always going to have the poor with us. There's a day coming when the old order of things will pass away. That is heaven, where there is no poverty. I can't wait for that day. In the meantime, I want to continue to worship in a way that emulates what Mary just demonstrated, that beautiful, extravagant outpouring at the feet of Jesus. I can't wait to worship with you in person at the Redemption Church.